How important is your vision to you? Imagine you woke up tomorrow morning and you had black spots obscuring your central vision. Sadly, for increasingly large numbers of people in the world, this has become their new reality. And I want to tell you about the 350 million people that this may be affecting and how the major players in the medical device industry are going to let them down, and how that creates a vacuum for small, innovative, and ethically driven companies to come and actually do some good. So I'm the founder of such a company. We're focused on the eradication of preventable blindness. And we're currently focused on type 1 and type 2 diabetes and the sight loss that that can bring. But how many people are we talking about here? Well, the truth is nobody really knows. It's somewhere between 400 and 500 million. Let's take this audience as an example. If you represented the world, 100 of you, I bet not point, 100 of you would be diabetic, but only 50 of you would know. The other 50 would be undiagnosed. 70 of you would go on to some kind of diabetic sight loss, and 5 of you would go blind. There are these huge numbers of people who don't know they're on this pathway to diabetic blindness. And anything you do in this space, because the medical device industry has become lazy and complacent, anything you do in this space is considered to be disruptive. For example, shipping devices to the developing world, or even talking about price. And that's one of the primary problems. So, if you look at the medical device industry in the round, most things are built and designed for the US healthcare market. It's the biggest market in the world. It's about $1.6 trillion in size. But what that means is that most of the devices are generated for that big market in the developed world. In the developing world, where most of the disease is, the devices just don't go. So if we look at diabetes, most of the diabetes in the world is in a swathe between the Gulf all the way up into Asia and Australasia. And so to illustrate the problem that we've got, I was in a tertiary level hospital in Delhi, which is a super, super specialized ophthalmic hospital. And I said to the guy in charge, what is it you need? What is it that would make your diagnosis easier? And he laughed and he said, well, nobody ever asks us this. The big companies turn up, they tell us what they have to sell us, we tell them we can't afford it, and they go away again. This guy was using a handheld ophthalmoscope from 50 years ago. So to illustrate the deadlock, to talk about the way out of this deadlock, what I want to talk about is our company's journey. We're a company of engineers. As it turns out, we're radical engineers. We're the enfant terrible of the medical device companies. Who would have thought a Scots company would be disruptive? So we make devices that are precisely focused on the disease. Well, what that means is that the engineering becomes quite straightforward because all of the things that are around the disease become the engineering constraints that you build around. So where and how it's going to be used just become two more of the engineering constraints. If you look at this picture here, this is where the majority of revenues are currently being made. This is our area of deployment. So you can see things like cost, safety, and clinical utility are the three principles of a medical device company, or so they should be. Well, safety, well, it makes perfect sense. You should always have a world quality management system with which you design and build the devices. Clinical utility, though, is the key. Once you focus on the actual disease modality itself, then it all becomes very straightforward. For diabetic retinopathy, for example, you need best quality optics, the best you can make. You need light, portable equipment, look at where we're deploying it. And you also need to focus very precisely on how you find the disease. Now, DR, which is what produces those black spots, those tiny blood clots, you need to be able to see that down around 10 or 15 microns, which is a tenth of the thickness of a human hair. And that's quite scarily small. You need the kind of optics, not that you'd find in your mobile phone, but that you might find in an astronomical observatory or something like that. And that's particularly difficult. So we've managed to build our device for something like 5 or 10% of the cost of these guys up here. And that is considered to be very disruptive. Not only that, we dare to name our price, which nobody else will do. So I just want to very quickly show you inside my eye. I'm the mad guy doing a live demo, the TED talk. So you can see there my optic disc, which is, I've got to say, healthy. We can do an exam in something like 2 or 3 minutes, not the half an hour or 45 minutes that it might take anywhere else. And I've got to say that we're able to do this, we're able to build all of this incredibly bespoke, high-quality equipment, because we are a small company. Our suppliers love us, they talk to us daily. And what I've got to say is, that vacuum that we were talking about, well, others can come and fill that vacuum with us, and we invite them to, because so long as you've got the innovative engineering, and you've got an ethical heart with which to sell your devices, then you can actually make this kind of a difference. Thank you.